Jethro is going to be going to his new home in just a few short days. These past 8 weeks with him have just flown by. Nevaeh's guardian family came up for a little visit. It's time for Nevaeh to go home. She's done weaning Jethro, and it's time for him to have a few days by himself without his mom before he goes off to his new home. Nevaeh's guardian family absolutely loved Jethro, and they were head over heels for how cute and sweet he was. But Nevaeh is excited. She's ready to go home, and we thank her for such an amazing litter. We just got a few more days with baby Jethro.
All right, well, it's vet day. It's time to take Mr. Jethro and the twins to the vet. The twins just have their last round of vaccines, and Jethro has his first set of vaccines today. So, two birds, one stone. We'll take them both, and we'll get an official weigh-in on Mr. Jethro. Yeah, okay. All right, off we go. You guys ready for the vet? You guys ready to go in?
The vet appointment went well for everybody. Mabel and Iroh got their last round of vaccines. Mabel was 52 pounds and Iroh was a whole 60 pounds. Jethro got his first set of vaccines as well and was a whopping 17 pounds. What a big puppy. Iroh had a small ear infection and the vet noticed a small umbilical hernia for Jethro, but otherwise everybody was in good health. It was a good visit overall.
Jethro is going home in a couple days.
Yeah, you're going to a new home in a couple of days.
Just in time for Easter,
right?
But there's a few more things we need to do. We need to get his puppy package ready, and we need to microchip him. So he's microchipped for when it comes to the registration, and just for his new owners. It's always good to have your dog microchipped. So we have to microchip Jethro. I do microchipping on my own. We have our microchip inserters and then our microchip reader too, just to make sure the microchip does get placed properly. So, I know this is for you, you're gonna get poked. So this is the microchip inserter. It's very small.
As I was saying, microchips are very, very small. They're only about the size of a grain of rice. You use the applicator to insert the microchip right under their skin between their shoulder blades. But as I was doing there, we always give it a quick scan just to make sure it's working and we don't have a faulty microchip. The great thing about microchips is if your puppy or dog were to ever get lost, all they would have to do is be scanned once they're found and all the owner's contact information would show up and help bring the dog home a lot quicker.
Give him a little massage because he didn't like his microchip. He has some pretty thick skin. And then we're gonna use our microchip reader. Just run it along his back. Make sure the microchip is implanted. And with the massage, that way we make sure that it actually did go underneath the skin and it doesn't get brushed away. So he has his microchip,
right?
And now he's ready to go to his new home.
And I'm better off this. Jethro's leaving this morning. This is Mama Daisy. She's having her litter later this week. But today is Jethro's day because Jethro is going to his new home. So he had his bath this morning. Now he's here to put his puppy package together for his new family. Is that a good sum? Okay. Off you go, handsome. So each of our puppies, for each of our puppies, we make puppy packages. They all go in giant doggy totes. I absolutely love the ones from Winners and HomeSense. They have the best dog patterns. Ow, that kind of hurts. Here. Instead of me, why don't you chew this? Ooh. Okay, ready? Okay. And these are just a few of the items that we put in our puppy packages. Most of our puppy packages are pretty universal. The only thing that might change, it might just be different toys based on what I've collected throughout the year. But for Jethro's puppy package, there's a few things in here. We have a little blanket that we're going to send home with him. Right? A little blanket for you. What do you think of it? Just something with familiar smells for him to help him transition to his new home a little easier. We're sending home two bags of treats. So these ones are Great Jacks. These are Canadian made. And they're really great, just simple training treat. Another is just some homemade treats that we've made. I shared the recipe in the past. These are just, he smells them. These are pumpkin flavored. Puppies really love them. Our dogs really love them. As you can tell, he's very excited about them. Yeah, I'm having these now. Jethro. And then we're going to send home a few toys with him. I'm going to let him play with them now because, as you can tell, he's ready to play. We're going to have to burn off some energy before his family comes because he has a few hours of driving to get back home. He's had this toy since he was born. This is one of the toys that Nevaeh adopted into her litter. So this is his sibling, just a giant bunny carrot. There, chew that. There you go. We have a shovel, and this one's just a stuffy shovel. It has a squeaker inside, and it says, "Life is a garden, dig it." Kind of going with like a spring Easter theme with this. And then just a little squeaker toy, just a little succulent plant. These will be the three toys in Jethro's puppy package. He sees the cat. But the cat don't care. Here, play with your bunny. We're also throwing in some poop bags because puppies are puppies. They poop a lot. There's a couple of pee pads we send home. I don't recommend continuing pee pad training once puppies go to their new homes. I use pee pad training here. It's just easier for me to manage litters that are litter box trained using pee pads. These are mainly just for the first night and for the drive home because some people do have a bit of a drive ahead of them. Then is his collar and his tag. He's a black dog, he has a black collar, he has a black tag, he's black on black on black. But his little name tag does have his name on it. Let's see if I can get the gleam right. Well, kinda. Here's his little collar. Let's put this on ya. Will it fit over your big head? Yeah. hold on. Hey, let's see, is it on the right way? Yeah, there we go. You got your name tag on now. Yeah, you got your name tag on now. I've mentioned in the past that we don't send home the 2-pound bags of Icana just because it's flippin' expensive and I'm able to send home more food for a better price. I'm filling them up in these little totes. So we get these little totes, we fill it up with food, there's a scoop.
A lot of people use this as a transition food. They won't actually keep their puppy on a canna, and that's perfectly fine. Everybody has different preferences in dog food. So at least we send this home. It's used as a transition food, so it's easier on the puppy's stomach to switch from one brand to another. But all the information is here. We have a canna, the ingredient list, and the feeding instructions too. But there's also a printout in the folder all about a canna if they want to continue using it. I think it's a great food. It's Canadian made, and our dogs have been doing very well on it. This also goes in Jethro's puppy package, home to his new family.
And of course, the most fun of all, paperwork. Of course, this has to go home in the puppy package as well. There is the agreement. This is a printed out copy. I do have an electronic copy that I get owners to sign. There's also going to be his vaccination passport from the vet with his dewormings, his vaccine, and his microchip information, all in there for his new family. We also send home a tick kit because ticks are very, very prevalent here in Ontario. A JDY business card. This is for 6 weeks of free pet health insurance. Some coupons for Whimsy, some information on the dog food, and some other brochures. Just like that, his family came to pick him up. He was nice and tired after our hike. Good thing, because he has a nice 2.5 hour drive home. And just like that, we spent the last 8 weeks together, and now it's time for him to start a new adventure in a new home, in a new city, with a new family. We wish Jethro all the best.